being a Trump.
Why do you hate my lifestyle?
I don't see the way you said it.
But like, if the t-shirt shop is watching around the corner, are you a game? I hope you want to watch around the corner.
No,
don't
get mad.
T-shirt lab. I want to take the space.
What are we gonna do right here?
You should show the card.
We're gonna get on camera.
No, I think they already got it
to you.
What this man has said to me.
Is your father? Do you think the people who voted for Trump, alright, me not being one of them, the people who voted for Trump are white supremacists, racist,
white supremacists.
I'm pointing right at him. Do you think that this guy who voted for Trump is white supremacist?
Oh no, I'm actually white.
Okay, some people are.
No, quarter Italian, quarter Irish, quarter German, quarter Cherokee. I'm almost as white as it comes, almost.
Italians used to be non-white 100 years ago.
But yeah, that's why I say almost, and plus the Cherokee Indian comes.
But my whole point is that they aren't. I think that and the whole problem, and the reason why Trump won is because people keep shouting and yelling that they are.
I'm not deaf, you idiot!
He will not divide us. I don't think he's dividing us. I think that the liberal media is dividing us. And I'm a liberal. I honestly think that MSNBC,
what?
CNN,
what?
These people,
what
are dividing
they?
Us.
Oh, okay.
See, he says he's liberal, but I'm kind of hesitant about that.
I'm not a libertarian.
I think it's libertarian.
Johnson, he's a fucking idiot.
He just wants to get high.
Legalize it.
I just don't see how.
It's destroying America to say that.
I wasn't planning to be here.
He doesn't like you like
I was here last night. I worked hard for the last 5 days coming here and entertaining you.
What the fuck? You just walk around. You're like a fucking idiot doing like this.
Yeah,
11 at night just looking at the camera like this.
Sitting on the fucking hood of your car.
Fucking air. If you like told me all of your political beliefs, I'd probably agree with almost all of them.
Every single one of them.
And that's why it makes me angry.
All of us.
I'm an advocate for a soul-like United States of America.
All of us in here. Yeah, no, see, now you sound a little bit like
you
Spencer, even though he would argue
all
the
wrong way.
Alright, like,
are you a homosexual priest?
Am I a queer clergyman?
No, I had a court date at traffic.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Sorry.
He's very professional.
Hey, girlfriend, we don't need your white male car for the
bullshit.
No, we do not
need
that.
You know who says the truth?
Cat Stevens.
Who is it?
I don't know. He's like probably somebody
who the fuck is
white supremacist. Cat says the truth.
What is that?
He's a fucking god.
I don't believe in your
god. He's Egyptian, so. So anyone, name a single issue political thing.
The wall!
Oh, where's
the wall?
I'm not for it. I don't. Alright, transgender.
People can do whatever the fuck they want.
unless a group of people, like if a school is like, hey, actually, you know, we're gonna build a new bathroom. Okay. Yeah. Alright, we don't want anybody who's
so like if a real woman gets raped by a transsexual woman in the transgender bathroom.
Also a dude can walk into a woman's bathroom and
so I'm trapped with the wrong body, I got a fix.
They're allowed, like the second you break a law, the law's been broken, you should go to prison for breaking the law. Yeah, and also rape and sexual assault is some of the worst things you can do, close to, you know, murdering children,
we just gotta make sure we have public defenders that are able to be there when the court case comes to play,
right.
So the DA doesn't have to throw the trial out, which happens here in Albuquerque all the time.
Right, but we also need the education on both the women and men side.
You know, I'd love to talk about this, but, you know, I gotta run, I got a busy life. Thank you.
Yeah!
What pissed me better, like, what, thank you for our...
It's because I spoke against his, like, male oppression.
Yeah, I think you should educate on both sides of, like, trying to stop women being raped. I don't even call it immediately. You know, like,
Roman at work.
Get a rape kit, go to a doctor, do, like, the steps necessary to get the DNA and the evidence necessary to properly convict somebody. And under any circumstance, you cannot say that in this specific area, like, in rape cases, you can't assume guilt. You know, like, you always innocent until proven guilty, no matter what. And it's like, it's a hard thing to say, because, like, a lot of the times it's un... You know, there is no proof, there is no evidence, it's a terrible thing for it to happen. But it's also a shame and not true to say that, like, all men need to be taught how to rape. Like, my little brother in high school right now, like, he knows rape is bad. Like, he doesn't need to be demonized as a rapist. Yeah.
A natural thing to know that sexual assault is.
Well, to his point, though, the education in this country is extremely
poor. In a lot of ways. But especially here in Albuquerque. Here in New Mexico, we have so much great public education.
I grew up in the South.
I really feel like you have to.
I grew up in the South, and they don't have sexual assault.
Actually, I beg to differ, because as somebody who lived 13 years in the South, I do have sexual assault.
Where do you live?
North Georgia.
Okay, Blue Ridge Mountains is not really. I grew up in Louisiana, Missouri, Mississippi.
I mean, if you say Alabama, the Blue Ridge Mountains isn't.
I mean, I talked to a.
There aren't 2,000 people.
I talked to a lot of
problems in front of a Walmart.
That's fine. I go to a lot of private schools and a lot of Christian schools, and they don't teach. They don't have sex ed. They don't.
I'm just saying.
I mean, maybe you're different. I mean, not everything is exactly evenly the same in this country. Yeah, yeah. But there's a lot of.
Well, I was just trying to break that generalization.
We do have sex ed, but it's just the dumbasses that can't.
No, but it's also the Bible Belt is responsible for some of the most egregious behavior in the entire nation.
Well, yeah. There's bad apples everywhere, but
the concentration of it is the Bible Belt.
The problem is when you have state politicians who are driven by religious values. And they want to inject their religious control through policies they enact in schools,
right?
You get lack of sexual education. I don't care who you are. You can look at the facts. They're written in bold letters.
I can subscribe my channel, Nick Chaos. I'm a gamer, right? That's to reach 1,000 subs. Let's make chaos great again.
Make chaos great again. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, I agree.
My brother's channel. So fuck it.
Well, of course, how could I?
SL1K_chaos. Like, subscribe, and bell for more chaos content.
You can separate yourself. You know, you have a line that you walk as a human being. You handle yourself with your own principles that were given.
I got me on Facebook también.
Your mother, and by what you believe in your heart. And when you take
no podemos separar los frijoles y los arroces.
How can I truly know 100% without a doubt that you're not putting policies in place of what you believe versus what the people are voting for?
Yeah, I agree.
It's a big issue that I have. Are we going to solve that issue?
So what? How is that represented itself? I agree with you. There's a lot of ways that it has, but what's a way that you would say that somebody's religious beliefs has been pushed in their politics?
With a recent example, just a recent example, Trump's Ivanka Trump, okay?
Right.
She is the First Lady of the United States.
Right.
Okay. She took to a public rally. Now, there's nothing wrong with a citizen getting up in a public space and saying the Lord's Prayer. I have no reservations about that. But if I, Jared Kellogg, I hold city council, or I hold mayoral office, or I hold government position, I got up and I gave an Islamic prayer,
Bismillah,
heads would fucking explode.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? And I would not be accepted as that person. You know what I mean? So that's just one little example that I have. But I grew up in a state where I had my science teacher, and this goes all the way down to just even people holding teacher values. You know, he said, you know, yeah, it says, you know, there's evolution, but guys, this is not true. You know,
what?
Here's the Bible, you know, and that happens. That's my personal.
This happened in a public school.
Yeah, it happens
in a public school.
New Madrid Elementary.
Missouri Elementary.
This was in a public school.
That's against my value system. Evolution is a fact.
Happened in a
public school.
But isn't it crazy though how the universe is chaos and so is everything is chaos? So you can't control every teacher out there saying to kids.
You cannot.
You can't. But if you can get politicians to spend money correctly, it's not like, oh, let's just throw tons of money at schools and we're going to solve the problems. But if you can actually take some transparency in effect.
It's a mic.
I know. Oh, this mic is actually really good. You can hear everything.
I know. It's for reals. You've seen the website, right?
Yeah, I know.
The microphones work.
I installed everything here that you see.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. It's pretty cool. I put up security cameras all, you know what's really cool about this, I think it's cool to me anyways, is I put security cameras with mics up all around the city. But so why wouldn't they put a slogan in front of it and now it becomes something?
It's all, yeah, you know, well, it's like,
crazy.
So well, at nighttime.
And normally we just like way the hell up there.
Yeah, so at nighttime.
They should have put a way the hell up there and just turn it down, but like
that was
people
were, you know, fucking.
So at nighttime is this an infrared camera?
No.
No, it's not.
It just has a little less writing.
Okay, it just goes black. Yeah. I was not.
It'll go black and white, and eventually the city will come and hopefully turn on the lights, but we've been...
So I have a question. What's everybody's opinion on drugs?
I think they should end the war on drugs. I think, you know, heroin is shitty. My brother has a major heroin addiction. It's destroyed his life, but... I think we should legalize
heroin. I think we should legalize heroin.
Yeah. It to hell.
Look, here's my biggest thing. Is
I don't know. I work in the...
Yeah, because I want to be on that.
I work in the security industry, so I see as kind of a liberal-minded somewhat person, I see a lot of the effects that drugs have on crime.
Right.
Okay? So people, when they're addicted to something, they have no money, how do they support their addiction? They break the law, right? You know, they steal things and crap. But... the biggest thing that I see is people, example, we caught a man who stole 26 different storage container units, felony possession, felony assault, felon, no drugs. He was arrested and out in 3 days. But I've seen another example of a man getting arrested with like a couple pounds of marijuana in his car, and he was in jail for like 3 months. You know what I mean? So, but one has to ask himself though, how much money truly is our government seizing assets from people who have drugs.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Think about it. You know, like if
probably I was already as much as if they were to fucking legalize it,
or if they were to just resell it. They confiscate everything and just resell it.
Or just not the whole facade. You know, the federal government had a cap on medical marijuana. It was established in 2003 by the state. The federal health department. You can look it up. There's a patent number on it. On the medical properties of medical marijuana. And what is the definition of medical marijuana? It holds medical properties. But the DEA, which is another federal government agency, says it's a Schedule 1 substance. It has no medical properties. That's a huge, and most, if you just go on Google, just search it. When did they just take the patent out? Here's the patent number. Go to the patent's office. It's still valid.
Pretend we're here.
But it's, again, this is another thing that I have with our government, is we have so many different agencies. There's no control over all these agencies. It's just, all of us, we just look to Trump as he's the, you know, everyone looks to the president as he is the most important figure in our government.
Our
he's not.
Governor?
We need to look.
State representatives? Yes. Our senators?
Our city council?
Our school board even has more impact on our daily lives.
Yeah. Amen.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Get involved in grassroots campaigns. Local government is very important. Know who your city representative
is. Vote in midterm elections.
Yes.
Vote for primaries.
Yes. Voting does count. It absolutely does.
Yeah, it's for real.
It's a real thing. It's an actual odds and numbers.
I think that a lot of the I'm all for, like, social change and everything like that, progressive ideas.
But I do think that, in a lot of ways, I would even consider the mainstream liberal base has become so progressive that it's regressing.
You know what causes that to me? We're a two-minded individual. We have our left and we have our right. We have two parties that dominate our government. We have the Democrats and the Republicans. Both parties are full of hypocrisy. I don't care what you say.
Totally.
So when you have, it's just the way the universe works. When you have two parties on either side, you get very little leeway or a way to come across that line to work with the other party. And a lot of it has to do with the media, I think. Because we've turned our politics into a reality TV show.
Totally.
He said, she said, scandal, scandal, scandal. Oh my god, oh my god. Shock factor, shock factor, shock factor.
Right.
And most kids who, that are our age, I don't know how old you guys are, but I'm 20, I'm in my 20s. You know, I'm a homeowner. I, like, work really hard to get to where I'm at. I'm a liberal-minded individual, and I have conservative values to a point. But, again, to your point, most kids our age, if you look at the voting numbers in your local areas, are so low. It's mostly people in their 50s, 60s,
oh, it's
and 70s.
All old people. Yeah. I help proctor the elections for me. Like old people show up to these things. Man, the funny thing is, I'll be out running or whatever, I'll say, hey, visit me for early voting, and people will be like, oh, they think that I'm, like, trying to canvass with them. I'm like, oh, no, I'm just telling you to vote.
Yeah.
I don't care what you do, just come on, vote.
I think that's the biggest, if we can solve that issue, and we can get campaign finance reform, big issue.
Wait, so you want to increase voting in the younger population, but also
I wish that
make marijuana legal.
This
I'm
works.
Telling you right now.
I like marijuana being legal. It's getting taxed a lot.
I think we have a ways to go in New Mexico with our governor. I would like to see a political drive to go into schools and educate people in civics and teach children what it actually means to actually, you know, instead of just watching videos on the screen of the bill, you know, like shit, like we need to actually take them to the voting booths and actually take them to the local courthouses and spend time and educating kids. Like, this is how the process works. I did not understand that process until I was like 22.
Hey,
like,
I'll see it. When I hand people the ballot, they say, I don't vote for anybody you don't know.
Right.
Hopefully you did some research.
Yeah, exactly.
But just vote.
The thing too is like, okay, so if I'm a Democrat, you know, I'm just gonna vote Democrat. I'm Republican, I'm gonna vote. Because every one of these people has the same exact values.
No, they don't.
Some people are really extreme, you know.
I was paid a lot by lobbyists.
Exactly. That campaign finance reform, my number one issue right now.
Isn't Trump trying to do something like that?
I doubt it. I mean, Trump himself donated $4 million to Hillary's campaign. I mean,
really?
Absolutely, that's a fact. Trump was Hillary. Yes, you can look it up. You can Google it.
Look at it now. I've never heard this.
Trump has supported Hillary Clinton.
Yeah.
He's a campaign donor. And I also think Trump should release his taxes. That's all I gotta say.
Wow.
That'd be nice. But I'm not going to go, you know, break windows and burn cars because I don't like Trump.
Other things to do.
I have a job.
Doing the laundry.
I have three jobs, by the way, you Twitter trolls.
Wow, three jobs.
Yeah. Someone pulled their Twitter.
How many glory holes are involved in them?
Zero.
Oh, you just made it.
Which may be one. Who's the band here?
I don't know.
So you think
probably ask the internet.
I go to a liberal arts school.
I went to a liberal arts school.
Coleman.
Jared,
I'm Arthur.
Arthur, nice to meet you.
Coleman?
Alright, so
it's called collaboration, people.
So. Yeah. Shia brought us together.
Yeah.
And,
New Mexico Public TV, right here.
She grew up in a small liberal arts college. And I would say that the majority of the student body believes that anybody who voted for Trump is a racist.
It's a sexist defeat for their biggest.
Now, I think that's ultimately divisive, and I think that it is the mainstream media's betrayal of that that is actually dividing our country. I think that the second you start saying that anybody who's done this, and it's half the goddamn country who did it, are racist, then like you instantly just like, okay, now it's a battle of morals.
In this society we live in today, we paint things with very broad brushes.
Our states are red and blue now.
You know, people will say Albuquerque is full of just trash, but it's actually not. Most people that I interact with here are very cordial and very responsible members of society. Like every other city in the United States, you have bad apples, you know?
A lot of meth heads. America. Walter White doesn't live here anymore.
Yeah, I know.
That's funny.